At Listen Up, we care about what you think. Pop by our website and answer this week's question. What do you think is the value of kids in sports today? We're at listenuptv.com. Welcome back. They play for the love of the game and for something more. Finding purpose in football. Ricky Ratliff brings us this report.
They might make their living playing a game, but these are big, tough guys. And their game is one punishing sport. But get a few of these fellows off by themselves for a while, talking about things that matter, things that really matter, and you just might see them in a whole new light. Retired Argonaut Chuck Winters grew up in the projects of Detroit.
It was, for me, sports was my outlet, and it kept me home, it kept me safe. I always said, oh, you know, I want to get into a profession or a job that I can get paid based off my talents, hence sports. You get paid off an interception, you get paid off in touchdown. So it was like, you know what, let me use the talents that God has given me to be able to take this and then have a productive life for me. Sports is my vehicle. It's, you know, it's what I did. It's not who I am. Who I am is a man of faith. That's all I have. And during those times when it was, you know, I didn't have sports, when I was traveling, all I had was faith. You know, I would sit there and be times when I'd be sitting in my room and just myself. And what do I have? My Bible.
How would your life be different without God?
I wouldn't be here. Period. I wouldn't be walking this earth. I'd be somewhere else. Because there's been times when I thought about taking my life because of the fact that it was just so difficult. And that's all I had to lean on. So it was like, you know, with him in my life, I wouldn't be sitting right here.
Argo's defensive back, Willie Middlebrooks, knows a thing or two about life being difficult.
I think God kept me strong at times I was weak. I think football kept me strong at times I was weak. It gave me a sense of ownership, a sense of pride. I don't know where I would be without either of the two, to be honest.
What would you say to a kid that's had a rough background and is considering life on the streets?
I would just tell him find something that he loved to do. The streets isn't where it's at. Find God. The sooner you find God, the better.
What have you learned from your mistakes off the field?
I learned that everything in life is should be dealt with in principle. Everything I think should be done in a serious matter, even if it's fun stuff, because your principle will still be the same. You should always do stuff to be good at it or the best at it. You should always try your best to be consistent, even if you lack in talent or lack in the knowledge. If you're consistent, you should be fine. And principle, I think, will help you be consistent. Everybody don't make the pros, but you can be a pro at heart.
First and foremost, I know that even when the chips are down, you still want to show the character that you have.
Argo's linebacker, Willie Pyle, is another player who finds faith a motivating force, even when the season isn't going well.
I really have to give it my all every time I step on the field because God expects no less from me. I believe that God has a plan, that he's using this right now, this situation that I'm in, to kind of teach a lesson. You know, and the key is to be so in tune, to have a personal prayer time, to have a quiet time where you can get in tune with what Christ has for your life and for my life, to really see what is going on. Where's the lesson? What should I be learning from this? I have to make sure my heart is right. And the only way I can do that is by continuing to pray and continue to seek his will and his wisdom for me personally in this season and then how I can affect my own teammates. And if I was to share one message, is that don't let your circumstances, don't let the things that's going on with you right now determine the outcome of what you want to be. Don't let it determine your success. You have choices. You know, I made the choice to choose to follow Christ because I know that my parents did and I was being a good kid then, but then I realized his impact in my life. You know, I made the choice to play football because it provided an outlet for me to use my abilities and to be around good people. And so you have a choice. And the question is, which choice are you going to make?
You know, it was a journey that had its ups and downs.
Argo's quarterback, Kerry Joseph, also came to a place in his life where he realized he had to make a choice for God.
Being a kid, going through the university level, just wanting to be that kid, you know, living the party life. Even though I knew about Jesus and what he has done for me, I still didn't have him at the forefront of my life. And going through some tough times, having my NFL career taken away from me, going through a divorce, it really helped me to refocus, to know that I had to put God back first where he belonged. My faith basically says for me to go all out. You know, I really look back and think about what Christ did for our sins, for our freedom. When I step out on the field, it's all out. It's to glorify God and to give 100% and to give Him my very best. And I know that when I do that, I'm not shortchanging my teammates because I'm out there playing all out every play in every game. And I try to live life the same way, to not waste a day.
Reporting from the Toronto Argonauts practice for Listen Up TV, I'm Ricky Ratliff.
There's more to come. When Listen Up returns, I'll share my personal thoughts on the game of football in The Wrap.